Hey everyone, Dr. Nick Delgado here. I'd like to share with you an incredible advent in the ability to help guide you towards your optimum health. Have you heard of NLP? More importantly, have you heard of the new neuro-reprogramming, which actually combines the best of NLP, timeline therapy, deep trance phenomena? All of these technologies are utilizing the power of the mind to help you to redirect your unconscious mind to accomplish your goals. I'm Dr. Nick Delgado, and I gotta tell you, we're excited to offer a coming event called NLP Weight Loss and Energy Workshop coming up April 19th. And if you've already seen this broadcast, then I want to encourage you to watch the full program. Why? Because it's really important to know the elements that will help you to accomplish your ideal health. First, I wanna honor the unconscious decisions that your mind makes. You know, over 99%, in fact, some say 97, but others say 99% of all decisions are made at the unconscious level. So your conscious mind is really only involved with between 1 and 3% of decisions. And that's important to understand because one of the reasons that you may have attempted to lose weight, increase your energy, accomplish a goal in your business, or improve your relationship is because you depended on unconscious behaviors, meaning they're already in programmed, they're already conditioned. So this is why we want to help you to learn about neuro-reprogramming. I struggled myself for years and I realized there was fear involved. I was fearful that there may be disappointment in failing if I attempted to lose weight and didn't lose weight. I realized that at times I might have thought I'm not enough and I'm scared. And I know some of my clients say, I'm scared and I may fail. I may put in all this effort to lose weight, increase energy, to change my diet, to exercise, put in all this effort, all for naught. It's not going to be that way. I want you to know that although there may be some hardship or loss, meaning maybe you can't eat that cake anymore, there's some discipline involved. And if you do eat cake, you eat a small sliver of it, so you just at least get the rush or the taste, but you don't go and eat a whole plateful of greasy, fatty foods. Yeah, there's some loss. You're gonna have to give up some things. But I wanna honor your struggle. I wanna tell you that it's gonna be difficult. And others may fail, but guess what? You're going to win. And I'm gonna share with you how you're going to win and why you're going to win. And the reason you're going to win is because I'm going to give you the most powerful technology on the planet. The most powerful technology is what's created all of human innovations. Man reaching outer space and the moon, creating powerful microscopes, which, by the way, I'm going to share with you on our screen, the inner universe. I kind of call it the Mr. Wizard. I don't know if some of you are old enough to remember Mr. Wizard, but he used to be on television and he would do these experiments with kids, not experimenting on kids, but he would show the kids experiments and it was really cool. And I learned a lot back then and it was always kind of wondrous and exciting. And that's how I feel like today, like a kid bringing you back this microscope technology to show you when you're failing or succeeding and how at the cellular level, but more importantly, how to make new decisions. So that being said, let's take you back a little further. When I was 22 years old, I was extremely overweight. By the age of 23, I had had my first stroke and I suffered this stroke, a TIA, it's a transient ischemic attack. I weighed over 205 pounds prior. I maybe in my younger years, I was at a better body weight when I was running, playing football, but I tried to bulk up to gain weight to play higher level college football. And I ended up gaining so much weight that after my football career was over and I injured my neck, I kept eating the way I was eating, much like Arnold Schwarzenegger's in the news today. And here's a man who's in history, one of the greatest, I think, athletes and actors. He's certainly acclaimed as a governor. I mean, he's accomplished so much coming from another country. But did you hear the news today that he has survived heart surgery? And they were only going to do minimal invasive surgery regarding a heart replacement for his valve, believed to be a genetic factor. But he admits to smoking cigars. For years as a bodybuilder, he ate lots and lots of meat and a lot of egg yolks. He even smokes cigars, and Sylvester Stallone, his good friend, says he's not going to give it up. It's like breathing air. Well, that's not something you really want to brag about. In fact, in more recent videos, Arnold, which I was backstage with him in March at the Arnold Schwarzenegger Sports Fitness Program in the award ceremony, where he interviewed Ronda Rousey and some other greats, and I was there too to interview these incredible athletes. We're going to post that here hopefully by tomorrow. But I wanted you to know that Arnold himself, having sustained a bodybuilding lifestyle, he came out on YouTube recently saying that he was going to work towards a plant-based diet, even towards a vegan diet. In fact, he said he's given up meat to a large extent, and he feels better than he's ever felt. I mean, this is much like Mike Tyson, whose doctor called me years ago, and he was searching for a way to deal with his estrogen dominance. And Mike Tyson now, if you check it out, he's definitely dropped over 100 pounds. He's in great shape. He's following largely a plant-based centered diet. And that's what it took for me. When I weighed over 205 pounds, I met Nathan Pritikin, and he called it a high complex carbohydrate, high fiber, low fat diet. He didn't call it a vegetarian or a vegan diet because people felt that was kind of placing a stigma on a attempt to work towards a healthier lifestyle. So I'm fortunate because after some great education and training and years of trial and error and discipline, I eventually not only reduced my body fat significantly and reduced somewhere close to 45 pounds in body fat, but I got in even better shape than I'd ever been before. So I know that after 40 years of following a healthy lifestyle, that you too can, and not just me. I have several examples of others. There's a picture of me shown here at age 58 from age 23. Actually, it was age 22 to 23, and then age 58. I'm now 63, and I'm as good a shape as I've ever been, and even better. I'm not bragging to you. I'm just telling you that I had a lot of setbacks in my life. I was exposed to fast foods at a young age. I avoided salt and sugar because I thought those were harmful, and white flour and things. But I ate a lot of meat, cheese, eggs, dairy product, and eggs, thinking that was good for me, and it was a big mistake. I think back how certain health professionals might have caused me to go off track for a while, but once I met Nathan Pritikin, who wrote a book, Live Longer Now, I realized that my life had changed and was changed permanently. I'm fortunate because I've guided other successful students. I remember Sheila of Canada. She came to us interested in improving her health. And it's interesting that I think the people who are most successful don't just change their diet and exercise. They change their mindset. She used actual hypnosis and what's called timeline therapy. She had met Dr. Tad James, who also I studied with Dr. Tad James. And Sheila, after following a supplement regime that we had designed for her, a whole food, natural diet, and exercise, you can see the before after pictures, rather dramatic and significant, achieving her ideal body weight, and more importantly, being able to keep it off for, like myself, for almost 30 in her years, in her case, and 40 years in my case. So I want to tell you that the hidden secret, the hidden gun, the hidden superpower is using the power of the mind. For some reason, we've all known about hypnosis and Milton Erickson going back probably close to 50 or 100 years, even goes back to Egyptian times. And yet, for whatever reason, we've never programmed the right information to help people to lose the weight. They always said food restriction, eat less food. Well, that doesn't work. You get hungry eventually. I used to starve myself. I remember trying to make weight for football. And the only way we were taught was run long distances, hard and fast, and get down to where eating only one egg a day and a little bowl of cottage cheese. Well, that only lasts so long. I suffered at night. I cried myself to sleep. It's not an easy way to go. And those of you who are starving yourselves and doing intermittent fasting and all these kind of programs, you're really going to be in for a surprise. Because we know that looking at Walter Kempner at Duke University, he helped people over the course of 1 year going on a whole rice fruit diet, high in fiber, low in fat, reported in the Annals of Internal Medicine 1949 that these individuals lost an average of 146 pounds in 1 year. There were several people involved in the study. They were in positive nitrogen balance, only getting 20 grams of protein a day, which also refutes the myth that you have to eat a high protein diet to lose weight. So I want you to know that you get all the protein you need. You'll get all the energy, the fiber, the vitamins, the minerals, and nutrients. But we go a step further. We also look at your hormones. We look at your mindset, your exercise. Because some of you are up against a genetic challenge. We know from studies in 1973 by Dr. Hansen, where they took rhesus monkeys, and they found out that some monkeys got severely obese diabetic, while other monkeys, eating as they ate accordingly, remained lean. So monkeys, when they're fed, they go on a high-calorie banana sweet potato diet. They'll leave the low-calorie vegetables because they basically feel satisfied eating the higher caloric density foods. So if you're trying to lose weight on carrot sticks and celery and you feel badly, you're not alone. Really, it's more important to realize that when visitors come to the zoo and feed these monkeys, they're feeding them leftover candy wrap. There's candy wrappers leftover showing they fed them candy. There's peanuts. There's a lot of high-calorie foods, and they feed them human food, and the monkeys get even heavier. So there's a known fact, and I've been to India, I've been to Malaysia, I've been all over the world where monkeys exist, and I got to tell you that there's a lot of myths about weight loss, but one of the first things you have to understand, there's a genetic factor when it comes to weight loss. So if you are genetically born with over 75 billion fat cells, some people are actually born with 300 billion fat cells, and when they eat the same amount of food as other people, they'll look massively obese. Others born with only 30 billion fat cells could eat almost as much food, and yet they'll never look overweight, they'll look slender, and we all hate them for it. We don't hate them, but the point is, you get the idea. Some people are able to lose weight without effort. Others gain weight just by smelling the food. I mean, almost literally. But food and genetics, we can override genetics because as we follow a healthy whole foods diet, guess what? We can shrink the fat cells. We won't ever decrease the number of fat cells, but we can shrink them. And we can shrink them by understanding the science of fat reduction. But most diet programs depend on a lot of myth to cause you to lose weight. That is deception. They depend on deception because the digestive tract, if you eat foods with little or no fiber, or you go on a starvation program, your intestines hold about 7 to 10 pounds of weight. So immediately within the first week, you'll look like when you step on the scales if you've lost 7 to 10 pounds. But that's only temporary. The moment you go back to eating foods sufficient to fill up the intestines, you'll gain the weight back. So that's a deception. That's not a real weight loss. Weight loss should depend on fat reduction, not just weight loss. And what about heat dehydration? A lot of people in these world's biggest loser contests, they know if, and even athletes before an athletic endeavor where they have to reach a certain weight, like in boxing, they'll dehydrate themselves for 2 days. You know, they'll get in the hot saunas, they'll stop drinking water, they'll dehydrate, they'll sweat the water out, because you can lose as much as 10 pounds. But the risk is if you lose too much water, you could actually die of dehydration. And some people have, especially using diuretics for bodybuilding contests to show ripped abs, and then they go and have so much fluid depletion that they die. Starvation, that's not an easy way to lose weight. Yeah, you'll lose glycogen, your muscles will start to digest, organ tissue, and fat is the last tissue to burn, the very tissue you want to burn. So don't depend on these ketosis diets. You're overly acidic, it's going to cause fatigue. I'm going to share with you a much easier way to lose weight than starving yourselves or going into ketosis. There's what's called a bomb calorimeter, and it measures the amount of calories your body has in relationship to the rate at which your body burns fat and fiber, protein, and carbohydrate. But it turns out fiber also burns in these bomb calorimeters, so when they take into account a high fiber food, they'll report it as higher in calories, like beans or whole grains, and than it actually is. You follow what I'm saying? So the fact that it burns calories and it burns up in a bomb, a burner, and liberates a certain amount of heat, is not the actual measure of the amount of calories your body can derive. Because when you eat foods high in fiber, a lot of the fiber just passes out of your digestive tract. It fills up your digestive tract, so you end up gaining that extra 7 or 10 pounds of weight. So while you're on a high fiber diet, you might appear to be gaining weight, but the reality is the net result is, since fiber is non-digestible, most of that food just passes through your intestines. You end up losing more weight than you have thought from month to month to month over the course. That's why in Dr. Kepner's study on a rice fruit diet over the course of 1 year, initially they didn't seem to lose weight in the first month, but after 1 year, they had lost 146 pounds on average and kept the weight off. In individuals weighing over 400 pounds, they reached their ideal weight of anywhere between 150 and 180 pounds or 200 depending on their body structure. Now, so keep in mind then, we're always gonna regain the fluid if we're dehydrated because ketosis, eating fat, and eating protein dehydrates the body, and it's deceptive. It's not real weight loss. When you eat starch-resistant complex carbohydrates, your body will hold in more fresh natural water. When you eat more fruits and vegetables, it has water in itself. And I always carry food with me and enjoy these rich combinations of corn tortillas, beans, vegetables, and fruit. And I'm always eating and nibbling on fresh natural food. I even carry some grapes with me to keep my energy up. And it really works quite well over a lifetime. I mean, I've been doing this for 40 years, oil-free, high fiber, high complex carbohydrates, starch resistant, adequate in protein, natural, essential fatty acids without excess oils or fats or processed foods. You can do it. It's the way you gotta go. So here is a caloric chart, and you wanna avoid the high fat calorie foods. The highest fatty foods are between 1,000 and 1,600 calories on this chart. Olive oil, margarine, butter. They're the world's highest calorie, and everyone thinks olive oil is a health food. It's not. It's the worst. It's the most toxic. Just like any other oil, it's mechanically sticky. And I'm going to show you on the TV screen what these oils and fats do here in a second. But keep in mind that maple sugar, even nuts and seeds are a little bit caloric dense. So if you're trying to lose weight, eat smaller quantities. But since they have fiber, they're good for you. But tacos usually have meat, cheese, and so forth, a lot of calories. So 700 to 900 calories. Look at the next highest calorie list is 500 to 800 calories per cup servings. Or in this case, I guess it's a half a cup. Kentucky Fried Chicken, Carl's Jr., pizzas. So look at nuts, hamburgers, cheese, and chocolate in itself is 400 to 700 calories. And so then look at ribs, 200 to 400 calories, pork, dark meat of turkey, the meat in burritos. And then look at salmon, chicken, turkey, eggs, milk, between 200 and 350 calories. And even fish, lobster, and scallops, and shrimp, although they're lower in calories because they're shellfish or the lower fat fish, not the salmon, but the lower fat, is between 100 and 200 calories per half a cup. All roughly 100 grams of food if you go by grams. So I want you to avoid these foods largely, and here's why. I want to change you over to this microscope, and one of my friends, should I use his name? Is it okay? Thumbs up or not? My friend Max, just before we did this show, we measured his cholesterol in this Cholestec machine, and his cholesterol came up to 224, which is high because it should be 100 to 160 in a person in his, 30s, and an HDL cholesterol of 47, which is good cholesterol, but his LDL cholesterol is 139. It should be under 95. Ideally, his triglycerides are 193. In the middle of the day, he ate some fatty foods, and his non-HDL 177, and his ratio is 4.8, which is high. His glucose is okay at 91. So I want you to zoom over here to the microscope for a moment, and this is his actual blood. Like Mr. Wizard, I'm showing you what blood looks like. This is a white blood cell right here. You can see the very powerful digestive juices. They're called lysosomes, and they're looking for viruses and bacteria and so forth. These little particles moving around, those are triglycerides. They look like a snowstorm. There's so much fat in his blood. And this is candida or fungus in the blood. And these larger round circles are red blood cells. So if you just take a look here, you can see in the center, that's the white blood cell, which protects you from viruses and bacteria and microbes and toxins. This is the red blood cells that transport oxygen and nutrients. So I want you to get this point. Whenever you eat a lot of grease, oils, and fats, all the fats linger in the bloodstream. They pour right into the digest tract, right through the blood vessels and coat all the blood cells in what Nathan Pritikin once called lipotoxemia. So let's zoom in a little closer so you can see this effect. See these little particles? That's like a food particle, but these little particles here are what's called Brownian movement. They're moving around because molecules are hitting them and pushing them around. So you can see the result of high fat. Now look at that white blood cell, how amazing and incredible. This is candida or fungus. This are the red blood cells where my cursor is. But you can see the fatty particles. Let me see if I can focus that a little better. It's a little hard to see, but I can see it really well. I hope you can see it on the screen, the triglycerides. So let's zoom back out, and I'm gonna show you a picture of my blood, which I took it just before we went on the set here. And here we go. So this is my blood eating fibrous fruit, vegetables, beans, peas, corn tortillas, and these are white blood cells here. Let me just show you here. This is kind of cool. This right here in the middle is the white blood cells. That's actually two of them, 1, 2, 3. This is the red blood cells. Now notice we're looking for fatty particles, but they're far and few between. Even though I'm not fasting, I'm took my blood in the middle of the day after eating fresh whole food, but I'm gonna zoom in so you can see the same comparison. But as I zoom in, I'm gonna read to you what my triglyceride level reading is compared to Max. Max's triglycerides is 193. My triglycerides in the middle of the day after eating is 110. My LDL cholesterol is 93. My HDL level's 39. My total cholesterol is 154, and my risk ratio is 3.9. My non-HDL is 115, and this is the middle day after eating, not even after fasting. So as you can see here, you can barely find a few triglyceride particles, which here, let me just show you that if you can see. See these little particles, those are triglycerides. So there's far fewer because there's less fat circulating in my bloodstream because I'm eating less fat in my diet. The fat that you eat goes right into the bloodstream and clumps up the blood, and it's very toxic and greasy. So I want you to get real clear about that, and so that you understand the importance. So if you ever have any questions how after 40 years we're able to determine what's the healthiest diet to follow, you can see how crisp and clear this blood looks. So when the blood is low in fat, why is that important? Because the blood cells go through the capillaries one by one and they squeeze through, exchanging their oxygen and nutrients. But if the cells are clumped together, as they clump together from all the excess fat, then it restricts oxygen going throughout the entire body. So I wanted you to at least get that picture. And once again, let's look at this blood again. Here we go. Let's see, that's the area where it's been exposed to air, so hold on a minute. Yeah, let me go here in this area here, we can see it a little bit better. Okay, and by the way, here's a toxic rod. You see that bacteria right there? Meat is usually loaded with microbes, so sometimes some of these toxic rods, or I've seen spirochetes, I've seen various types of microbes that tend to increase the risk of flu, viruses, cold, bacteria. But again, much more fat in the blood. Here's the white blood cells trying to do the job, but there's so much fat in the blood, it's gonna be a struggle, you know, for this individual's blood and circulation, which will make him sleepy. Then he'll need coffee, and then coffee will wake him up, but then that's gonna be a problem because then it's hard on the adrenals. So, okay, I hope you kind of get a sense for what that was about. Now let's switch over to the low density, high water content foods. The lowest calorie foods on up to the medium calorie foods for fruit. Look at fruit, like if you include tubers like yams and potatoes, leeks and so forth, and you look at fruit, somewhere between 60 and 120 calories, which makes it the ideal perfect food. Fruit itself, like watermelon, apples, and cantaloupe, has only 20 to 60 calories, and vegetables like mushrooms, cucumbers, eggplant, cabbage has only 20 to 40 calories. So keep in mind that for the same amount, a half a cup to a cup of vegetables or fruit, in the weight of 100 grams, is the ideal food to eat as much as you wish, and certainly keeping in mind these are the fresh, whole natural foods that it's difficult to overeat because you're gonna reach your ideal weight simply by the fact that it fills up your stomach, you're satisfied, and they have the least amount of calories. And I don't expect you to only eat vegetables and fruit, I get that, but when you're trying to lose weight, have some more vegetable soups, have some crock pot, make some more salads with oil-free dressings. All these foods are going to be your friend to eat as much as you want without starving to help you to lose weight. But there is a limit on healthy, good, healthy, medium calorie foods, because if you eat as much as you want, like the genetically tendency monkeys that gain too much weight, if you ate too much sweet potatoes and yams, beans and peas and brown rice, although it's 120 to 145 calories, that could add up if you ate, say, 20 cups worth, that would be 2,500 to 3,000 calories. Now notice that things even more dense would be raisins, dates, olives, avocados, soaked nuts and seeds, chestnuts, coconut, almond. All these are upward to 160 to 600 calories. So if you ate, say, 10 cups of these particular foods, that could be 3,000 to 6,000 calories. And you don't want to eat that many calories if you're trying to reduce some weight. But if you're underweight and you're too skinny, raise your hand if you are. Some of you are. As you approach your ideal body weight, remember these are the foods that will be your friend to mix in more to sustain your ideal body weight. So that being said, it isn't just about fruits and vegetables, beans and peas and yams. That includes tasty Asian food, because Thai, Chinese, Vietnamese, Japanese foods have a wide variety of a lot of tasty methods of preparing vegetable dishes, soups, veggies, sea vegetables, spicy foods. In Italian food, there's minestrone soup, salad, spaghetti sauce, fat-free tomato sauce. American food, you can even go to the salad bar if you're very careful about what you choose. Eat more soups, of course. And in Greek food, hummus and eggplant is great. Mexican food, beans, rice, and corn tortillas, fajitas, vegetable fajitas. So there's a lot of varieties from international cuisines using spices and flavors to make these foods taste wonderful. When I'm at home, I also take about three or four different big pots, and I'll start a crock pot, and I'll cook boil some water, put various vegetables, I'll add various spices, and I'll cook a bulk of food that I can put in containers like this and carry it with me to my office every day. That way, in my container, I actually bring this container every day. My staff knows I do this, and I bring that container with a frozen blue ice, and I put it at the bottom, so that way I keep my fresh food, and as it's fresh, it keeps my energy up, and it makes it delicious to eat and nibble on through the day as I get hungry. So I know there's a lot of people that believe in eating only about two meals a day and fasting most of the day, but guess who gains the most weight? Sumo wrestlers. They eat only one meal a day. Their body thinks it's in starvation, so it retains all these calories based on their hormonal ratio. And when they do eat this big meal, even if it's tofu and vegetables and beans, and they don't eat much vegetables. They eat concentrated foods like tofu and rice and sometimes meat. And these sumo wrestlers get really big, huge, right? So don't default to one or two meals a day. You want to eat whenever you're a little hungry, a little weak. Eat five meals a day, six, but don't eat when you're not hungry. If you're not hungry, don't eat. As you are overweight, you may not find yourself needing to eat as often. And when you're underweight, you'll find yourself needing to eat even more often. So keep in mind, there's other factors that cause weight gain. There's what's called estrogen dominance. And both men and women have become terribly obese now because of a problem called estrogen dominance. We're exposed to not just chemicals in the environment, but meat and chicken and lamb. All of these things are loaded with estrogen because they have estrous cycles. They have monthly cycles. They're loaded with hormones. Even if they don't pump them full of hormones, they have a ton of hormones, particularly fat-retaining hormones. Like estrogen. Fish has BPA, which is a type of toxin that collects in the oceans from manufacturing plants, and the fish is loaded with an estrogen-type toxin. So the way to detoxify this is eliminate the meat, cheese, eggs, and dairy product and the fish and go to plant-based foods. But if you're not able to make all the eliminations possible, then start off with our award-winning EstroBlock Triple Strength. This is the one that will help you to reduce body fat because it converts the bad estrogen to a good form of estrogen. And then with a methyl donor, with our new Neuro Insight, it'll help detoxify and exit that harmful estrogen out the body. This is a proprietary blend, very special ingredients mixed in that with the right type of absorption. Ours has got the best absorption of any product out there. No one's been able to duplicate it. We hold our formula secret. It's a very unique and awesome, incredible product that's probably our number one selling product around the world. Not only does it help people with estrogen dominance, it's been helping kids with acne and skin problems. And I have a whole book coming out, Annihilate Acne Now Naturally. We have the revised edition coming out very shortly. So I just wanted to show you that book. And also, when you're thinking about recipes, since we just covered the eating section, make sure you get my book, Simply Healthy Cookbook, and this is going to help you quite a bit. So what is another cause of fat retention? Another cause is called thyroid deficiency. Hashimoto's is a severe form of low thyroid, the inability to sustain the production of healthy thyroid. And there's, of course, hyperthyroidism, which is elevated too high. But hypo or low thyroid conditions often occur from lack of iodine. And we know that some children suffer myxedema. They develop not autism, but actually mental retardation, mental deficiencies, because the iodine is necessary for proper brain function. Thyroid is necessary. So not only do we need enough iodine, which iodized salt used to give us some. Now breads have bromide instead of iodine. Salt doesn't always have iodine in it. You have to go out of your way. So we use a product called rat iodine, and this gives you 30 milligrams of iodine, which is a potent dose. And you only need one or two capsules a day, but initially, if you're deficient, take it every day, and after a few months, measure your iodine levels with a simple drop on the skin. See if it stays dark for 24 hours. If it doesn't and it disappears, then your iodine is being sucked into your skin. It means you're very, very deficient. So if you have cold hands or feet, shake hands with someone you're with. My hands feel warm and toasty, the feet, because I maintain my iodine levels at a very good and my thyroid levels. A tendency to gain weight, that's another sign of low thyroid. Low energy, low sex drive, another sign of low thyroid. Poor mental function, brittle nails, aging skin, slow hair growth, or even hair loss. We use a product called Nature Throid, and that is a product that has T3, T4. It's amazing in combination with the iodine, or just take the Nature Throid by itself. We can evaluate with a simple finger stick test, your free T3 test. There's some additional tests that might need to be done, but we can consult with you and give you some advice on that. And why do people have addictions? Addiction particularly to food. This is the biggest reason why people fail when they're on a weight loss program. I failed originally because I couldn't stop from overeating. Even if it was healthy food, I'd overeat healthy food. And I mean, not just, you know, the vegetables and carrot sticks and fruit. I would eat large plates of rice and beans and yams, which have more calories, and it caused me to gain some weight. The classic example is Elvis Presley. He died at the young age of 42. I didn't realize he was only 42. He was addicted to over-the-counter drugs prescribed by his physician. He ate a lot of junk food. He was on barbiturates and Demerol. He basically, a good example of what he would eat, he felt like he was starving. I know what that's like, because I used to have this low cortisol adrenal dysfunction. And even if you eat a lot of food, you never quite feel satisfied. Have you ever had that experience? Or if you're addicted to alcohol, one drink isn't enough. Or, you know, if you take drugs, you get high and you feel better temporarily, and then you're always addicted. So it's hard to imagine, but Elvis Presley would start off with six large eggs cooked in butter, a pound of bacon, a half a pound of sausage, 12 buttermilk biscuits. For dinner, he'd have a 1.5 pound of ribeye steak, hamburger, deep fried bread. And every night he'd have a rolled stuffed bacon, peanut butter, strawberry jam sandwich. At 4 in the morning, he'd wake up and have a double hamburger, deep fried peanut butter, mashed banana, which was the only good thing he ate, I think, lemon meringue, or sweet potato pie. His average intake was 94,000 calories a day. It's no wonder Elvis died. He was also drinking booze, Darvocet, and he died of a heart attack. And so I think about that when I look through the literature, and I realized he had adrenal deficiency. Just like Robin Williams had adrenal deficiency and was addicted and admitted to having to be checked into drug rehab. Whitney Houston, addicted to alcohol and drugs. These are signs of adrenal deficiency. How do you know if you have adrenal deficiency? There's a simple test for adrenal function that's done in the urine test, and also best done in saliva in this case, because saliva measures cortisol. Cortisol is your friend, and if it's too low, then you have potentially adrenal dysfunction. If it's extremely low in the morning, you might have difficulty waking up, getting going. Cortisol helps to push sugar, fatty acids, and amino acids into the cells to give you energy. So the reason that you may be addicted to food, alcohol, drugs is because if you don't have enough cortisol, it won't push the calories into the cells and you'll always feel hungry and you'll keep eating and eating till you overeat. When you sustain good adrenal function, then you'll find a small plate of food will be enough and you'll wait till your next meal and you'll be fine. So many of these people have a physiologic addiction, and we've discovered a product that I created called Adrenal DMG. And adrenal function is adrenal cortex. It has certain herbs that support adrenal function, and DMG, which helps liver function. But it basically helps with the whole cascade of energy cycle that the body needs. And then as you feel good, you're no longer going to find the addiction. It's going to take some psychology, maybe some timeline therapy, some other interventions with deep trance phenomena and some neuro reprogramming. Dr. Susie Shooter is a famous psychiatrist who's worked for years with Dr. Terry Hertog and reported this in the annals of New York Academy of Science, and reported in 2005, that far back, reported also did some work at Newport Beach Hogue Hospital. But she has been in the past used Adrenal DMG. We have the new product called NeuroInsight that's a methyl donor. And all this, without going into a lot of detail, we have a special program right now. I want to call your attention to the board. NeuroInsight, we're giving away the brand new product to a few lucky winners each week. If you go on Instagram to Esterblock Protocol, and you look up the giveaway program and what's involved, you can win a 6-month supply of NeuroInsight. Also, if you're interested, you can go to Delgado to Instagram, that is, and look for the Delgado Protocol, and you can get a 3-month supply of Testervita to enhance your testosterone levels. Well, these are novel new products, and I want people to get excited and get to use them and try them and give us some reviews, please. But I'm really excited about what this can do for you. Keeping in mind Testervita, transitioning to what's important to having sustained energy, is having a good muscle density. Muscle density comes from correct training. I love to do pyramiding, where you take heavier weights, and as you get tired, you progressively drop the weight and continue to do the sets. It's a good way to overcome fatigue. I like to train daily outdoors. Why outdoors? Because the sun gives you a buildup of natural cortisol. The sun stimulates with 500,000 lux of energy. It stimulates the release of these very healthy hormones to improve adrenal function, to improve thyroid function. The sun also helps release more testosterone by increasing what's called luteinizing hormone. The outdoor daylight is so important. So I love to train outdoors. It's one of my keys to success as I age through the decades. I'm able to train competitively against a lot of the young athletes, as you know, and I offer the $1,000 challenge. Any day of the week, come down to our office, go to the beach with me. We'll choose a set of dumbbells, and let's see if you can keep up with me. Having participated at the Arnold Classic at 3 major competitions and in London in the World Championships, I know what it takes to train at a high level. And I love training competitively and just to stay in shape. It's just wonderful. But having good adrenal levels is critical. If your adrenal levels are low, you'll train hard and crash and burn, develop a cold or flu or congestion. I have a really great book on here called Safe Uses of Cortisol by William McKinley Jeffries. I don't know if we can pick that up on the camera. Thumbs up if we can. But this is a great book that teaches you how to balance your adrenals. And it really gets into the safe uses of cortisol, not adrenal cortical steroids, which is prednisone and the new class of drugs that tends to be overly aggressive and increasing, because you don't want too high or too low of cortisol levels. But this is how I discovered how to balance the adrenals, not just daylight, lifestyle methods, eating properly, making sure you take a product, as I mentioned, Adrenal DMG. I also, now that I'm talking about Testervita and cortisol and balance, Jeffrey Life is a good example of a man here, age 54 shown, quite obese, overweight. At age 64, he got in great shape through training, through using natural bioidentical hormones. But by the age of 77, he transitioned to a plant-based diet, got in even better shape. He's leaner than ever. He overcame heart disease. He had coronary heart disease. And that's why one of the reasons, even if you're young and you have high cholesterol, or if you're my age and you sustain a good cholesterol level, chances are you'll prevent or avoid a heart attack by following a good, healthy overall diet. So what is neuroreprogramming? We use focus, concentration, brain function, and I want to tell you about a case study of Colleen Grajeda. I met her years ago in a hospital. She worked in the cafeteria and she was quite overweight. She said, look, I just want to get into designer jeans. My thighs are just too big. And I said, well, if you follow what I'm going to teach you, I'm going to give you some programming scripts, as you will. So I've been using this for years. And she followed the scripts, listened to the information. Those days it was audio cassettes. These days we have some more advanced ways to download to your phone if you go to our website, DelgadoProtocol.com. But those of you who get started working with us, you're going to find out, like Colleen Grajeda, within 1 year she could fit into her designer jeans. She reprogrammed her mind, and now for over 30 years later, she's still following a healthy approach and program. I know you can do it. It's really great. And in our coming April 19th event, we're going to teach you how to direct your unconscious mind. We're going to show you the 5-second rule. We're going to talk about Richard Bandler's work in The Guide to Transformation. We're going to talk about my work with Tony Robbins, Awaken the Giant Within. You're going to learn how to reprogram your mind and your body. Tune into DelgadoProtocol.com and go to events, and there you're going to see one of the past broadcasts. But more importantly, you're going to get to see this live stream. And from birth until death, we move in the direction of our dominant thoughts. We can do and we must act out what is planted into the mind, rich or poor, fat or thin, smoker or non-smoker. So I'm going to teach you how to plant in your mind how to be successful and change this. Within 7 days, your mind will change like a Richard Bandler. It changes that quick in a heartbeat, the moment you make that decision. And then within 30 days, your new habits will replace your bad habits. And if you read these scripts every night, and when you do, those of you who are joining us are going to find your unconscious mind will work on these processes all night long. And within 30 days, after about 3 to 6 months, you're going to be totally transformed. You're going to see yourself eating healthy, looking better, feeling great. And really, you're going to find yourself making a choice of really eating unprocessed foods and whole naturals and avoiding the sugars and fats and the calorically dense foods. And you're going to feel better week after week, day after day. And I'm just showing you examples of some of these scripts and some of the mind mantras that we use. But it's neuro-reprogramming at its best. You're going to find that you can actually give up these harmful, terrible foods. And as you sit down, you'll feel a sense of pleasure and satisfaction in making this choice. As you move toward oil-free, you will feel no desire to deviate from this. And although you might have some setbacks at times, your net result, your goal, your gain will be tremendous. And so keep in mind, and as you follow this lifestyle, eating simple, whole natural foods, get my book, Simply Healthy Cookbook. You can download it at our website. When you come to our event, we're going to be giving also a special book called High Performance Habits by Brendan Burchard, my good friend. And I think you're going to find this is a cool book as well. Some of his techniques in discussions I don't fully agree with, but his mindset is great, and I think I want you to get that book. Simply Healthy, again, this cookbook, you really want to get it. Thumbs up if you got it zeroed in here on the camera. Can you see it? Great. And my other book, Stay Young, is more for joint health. I want you to take a look at that. But it talks about inflammation processes and what tests to do and how to get healthy joints and limbs. So keep in mind, consistent action will yield results. Even if you've failed in the past, this is the program for you. This is the program if you want to feel great, make love to life, enjoy your exercise, meditate, and choose the right foods. Some of you will respond abnormally to stress, and we're going to give you some techniques to overcome that, and it's going to be one of the best programs you've ever attended. We're going to teach you which supplements work best, how to fit in a whole natural foods diet, what exercise, and how to go about moving your body at a high level, and how you'll have more energy than you've ever had in your lifetime. I know, I look back at a time when I set my goals in a deep state of relaxation. We're going to teach you some of the best books, the best methods, and really, this is a total mind-body approach to relaxation and approach, and I'm going to share with you limiting beliefs and challenging behavior. So I'm going to end with one simple technique. It's called timeline. I want you to just close your eyes for a moment or just relax and imagine your mind relaxing with every number as I count down, or 100, 99, 98. Your mind is now 10 times more relaxed than it was before. 97, 96. Now it's 100 times more relaxed than it was before. Now relax your body. 100, 99, 98. And as I count downward, your body's more relaxed than it's ever been. 78, 76, 74. Your body, your mind is totally relaxed. Now float up above the room, pretending you're going up above the clouds, above the stars, looking down one day before you had that limiting belief that you cannot lose weight, or I can't have energy, or I'll never find the mate of my life or success. Whatever it is, now I want you to embed this positive belief that taking love through the top of your head throughout your entire body, finding that place where you feel self-love and you're able to increase your energy and lose weight, see yourself 1 month from now, 3 months from now, 6 months and a year, and 10 years from now, and you'll see that you too can accomplish these incredible results. Now, as you return back in the room, return only so fast, as you're willing to release all these negative beliefs and unfounded, unwarranted, limiting factors, yet let go of the anger, the fear, the guilt, or the belief that you can't accomplish these results because now you can. And as you do, your unconscious mind will let go of words like, I can't lose weight, or I can't afford to change my diet, or I have difficulty losing weight. All these things have nothing to do with the reality of I can, I will, and I must. So enroll in our coaching program. It's available now. That special program is going to be offered this month in April for the astonishing low rate. There's an application enrollment if you want to have me as your personal life coach. I do take on some special elite and business-minded individuals, individuals who are trying to accomplish incredible goals in the world, and I'm here to help you. But my staff is here to help you. We have the elite program, the prestige program, the free seven-day trial program. We're going to have some exciting seminars, webinars, and podcasts. And if you tune in each week, I'm going to have a series of broadcasts here. So just find us here. There's an application on our website, and we'll get you started. And we'll also determine what products are best for you. So if you're ready for me, and I'm ready for you, which is right now, this is Dr. Nick Delgado saying be well, be strong, and let's look forward to our next event. Come on and tune in. And I'm here to help you. So in the chat, please share this with your friends. Please let us know what you think and give us any feedback that would make sense. Okay? Be well. Thank you. Dr. Nick Delgado, say visit DelgadoProtocol.com. That's DelgadoProtocol.com right here, DelgadoProtocol.com. And I thank you very much.